Once it is hardened, the orthosis must be tempered in an oven for 1 hour at 60 degrees Celsius. Remove the orthosis from the oven after the first tempering and allow it to cool. Expose and remove the dummy anchor nuts. Make sure that the upper section of the anchor nuts, where the joint unit is later applied, is clean. Remove any resin residues. Next, remove all the screws from the medial support dummy. In some cases, you may need a saw to expose the dummy. Remove all screws from the ankle joint dummies and joint alignment adapters. Use an oscillating saw to expose the orthosis shells. Make sure you saw through the inner shell at the level of the knee joint. Remove the orthosis shells from the model. Sand the orthosis shells according to the shape of the trim lines. To ensure the shells are skin-friendly, they must be tempered a second time. Do this by placing the orthosis shells in an 80 degrees Celsius oven for a further 10 hours. Mount the ankle joints on the foot stirrups. Mount the medial support on the medial lamination bars using the supplied screws. Then, screw the adapter plate onto the anchor nuts of the lower leg shell. Mount the seabreeze joint unit on the orthosis shells. Secure the screws using a torque wrench and Loctite 241. Tighten all screws of the joint unit and adapter plate to 7 Nm. Tighten the screws of the medial support to 6 Nm. If you unscrew the joint unit from the orthosis, for example, for servicing purposes, all anchor nuts have to be cleaned afterwards. Make sure that there is no leftover Loctite 241 residue in the thread before you screw the joint unit back on and secure it with a torque wrench and Loctite. Make sure that the orthosis shells do not collide with the joint module at full flexion. If this is the case, part of the thigh or lower leg shell has to be sanded back. Mount the foot component with the ankle joints and fill the gaps beneath the lamination bars with petelin or foam.